What's up, everybody? Nathan here at Nalitech Studio. So welcome back. So today we are looking at the renovation filters. And to understand this, we need to start with a blank canvas right here. So we're going to imagine a small existing building that we want to make changes to. So for that, let's pick a wall and perhaps let's pick a boxy kind of construction method. And we will do something simple. So I will tab here and say 10 meters, for example, by 5 meters. So this is the residence that I'm imagining, and perhaps it has a floor. So I'll pick a slab for that and I'll draw a simple floor there, and perhaps it has a roof as well. So I'll pick the same slab, Control C to copy, and I'll go to the first floor and Control V to paste, such that we have a roof for it, which is going to be a simple slab. And now on the ground floor, to add a little bit of interest, we're going to add in some openings. So these openings, I can pick a default door for that. And in order to snap a bit more openings, I can come here on this icon and set some snap points here, and I will use 5 in this case. I say okay, so that I'm able to create like 4 openings here. So I will set that to the division 5, such that when I hover over here, you can see those snap points. So I imagine one entrance here, perhaps an exit there, and perhaps we have some more, like one here and another one here, just for demonstration. And another thing we could do to add a little bit of interest is to imagine like we had a separation in this building. So we will pick a simple wall which is already existing, and let's take back our snap to half and pick just a simple wall here, and let's use the midpoint here and imagine this wall came all the way up to here to divide these two. Perhaps this was unit 1, unit 2, and this floor expanded. Let's add here by adding to polygon something like half this way and half that way. And yeah, let's not do a lot more for this design and see it in 3D. So this is what we have, which is a cool design here. But we want to be able to make some changes to this. And for that, ARCHICAD has a nice tool, which is the renovation filter. And to find it, you just have to go to the window, palettes, renovation. And there you have it. So this is the palette. And by default, all elements that you are working on are set to the new construction here. This is a to be demolished icon, and this is for the existing. So everything is set to new, which is reasonable because, you know, when you open ARCHICAD, you want to do a new project and nothing is existing. But we need to be able to select everything here and tell ARCHICAD that this stuff is supposed to be an existing project. So every element that I select is highlighted to be an existing thing. And we want to go further by telling ARCHICAD that perhaps the client wants to have a bigger space, so he's going to demolish this wall, for example. So we demarcate that to be demolished. And perhaps we want to also replace these two doors here and create one big door. So let's select those two and say to be demolished. And then also we need to put in what we want in the settings. Let me pick a simple empty opening here, a rectangular one at that. I'll say okay, and just using the defaults, place it in this existing wall. I will expand it to this side and as well take it all the way to there. Just make sure that that opening is in the new construction. Another thing we could do is to pick one of these walls, just making sure that we are still on new construction, and propose a wall, for example, because, you know, a common thing you want to do on renovations is to add more space to the building. We are adding, we are reclaiming this space here to be new construction. There we have it. It's in the new construction. And then we want to roof it. So I'll pick one of these, this slab, making sure that it is on that layer. Just come in and zoom in here. Let's do this stuff in 3D so you can see it in real time. There we have it. We have proposed that wall, and perhaps we need an entrance, a mega opening there. So we will use just the default. So in the window settings here, I'm going to go in sliding doors and pick Yeah, like this default, nothing fancy. We just need to put it somewhere like there. And of course, we need to kind of position it in the center such that it doesn't look terrible, but that is it. So right now it looks a bit messy, what we have been working on, but show you some interesting things. So for example, if we go where you see show all elements, if we say go to the existing plan, you can see that we go back to where we began, which is really cool because we have not lost anything yet. And if we go back here and say, show us the demolition plan, you can see that now we have highlighted the things which we want to demolish on this design. So if we say, for example, what happens after demolition? There you have it. Those elements have been removed. And then now we say, what if we want to look at the new construction? There it is. It's being highlighted. And then finally, of course, we want to show the proposed status, which is going to remove everything that we have said that is going to be demolished and leave just that which is going to be the new building. And this is actually the basics of renovation filters. So if we go to the floor plan right here, you can see that right now it's showing so many things, which is not be helpful because we are here in show all elements. But if we say existing plan, you can see that's a more helpful plan, which you can save differently. And then if we say demolition plan, you can see that we have a plan which highlights the things that are going to be demolished. After demolition, we have this simplistic plan, which is showing everything. And new construction, you can see the things are being highlighted. And you could as well change what these look like in the representation. If, for example, you're not happy with the red color coding, you can go to document, renovation, and then renovation filter options, because this is where you determine, for example, here in new construction, you can go in graphic overrides, and this is the rules which tell us what existing elements should be like, what elements to be demolished are going to look like, and what elements are to look like. For example, if in your country, new elements are coded like blue, we can decide to do that. For example, let's choose maybe that kind of blue, and perhaps we have another one, just different shades of blue to show what we want to show. And perhaps also in 3D we can choose a, I don't know, glass blue or something, and we say okay. You can see that this stuff has been changed to that color coding. So now when we say okay, you can see that the new construction is being coded in blue. And also the other plans also change here in 3D. If I change the status to the new construction, you can see the highlighting of new things which are being proposed, which is kind of a nice way to communicate these, you know, ideas of the stuff you're proposing or adding to an old design. And of course, the final plan, which is the proposed status. When all is said and done, let's jump to this project here, which you saw at the intro of the video. So if I go, for example, to the existing model, this is kind of how the situation was of the things which were existing. So I had some planters here, and we wanted to be able to expand this space for a restaurant. And it made sense that we demolish these columns, these two columns, and you know, I was not happy with these planters, so I proposed to be demolished. So after demolition, you can see that those planters disappear, two columns here disappear, and I also made the opening at the back much bigger. And after all is said and done, we have the proposed renovation, which brings everything that I imagined to change to, which is kind of a nice way that I do not need to keep duplicating this stuff and then doing each and every different plan. But using renovation filters, it's really possible to do something awesome like this, where you just work on one model, do a bunch of things to it. This is really powerful. If you're preparing like plans, for example, you can see I have an existing ground floor plan. If I open that, you can see that this is the existing situation. And when I go to the settings of it, I have the renovation filter put set as existing plan. That would change if I opened, for example, my demolition plan here. You can see that the things that are to be done have been highlighted. Replace these existing planters, demolish this wall, demolish these two columns. And after all is said and done, we have this, which is the proposed ground floor, which discards everything and zooms into the main subject, which is this thing here, this floor plan here. So those are the basics of renovation filters. So I hope you learned something. Don't forget to subscribe if you're new to this channel and give us a like. It really helps this channel to grow and be recommended to more people. So otherwise, that's been it. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.